Oh, the Lord said that.
Yeah, he said
it's God that did wonderful works.
Yeah,
but go ahead.
He said, and then I will confess unto them.
What the Lord gonna say to
you? I never knew you.
The Lord can still spit you out, bro. Right? So don't think you special just because you got a lot of people listening to you that came in the truth, saw you on the street teaching. All right, you still gotta be humble, bro. Go ahead.
I never knew you.
So the Lord say, never knew you. Go ahead.
Depart from me, ye that work iniquity.
Because you wicked, man. And ye that work iniquity. Now get me old. It's a lot. No, you old, what you got. Get Hebrews 8:10, bro. He said, ye that work iniquity, depart from me. Now I'm going to show you something.
You got the Bible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's what you got, Israelites?
Israelites. Yes, sir. Men of the Lord, Israel. Yep. Teachers of truth. What you got,
huh? He said, this is Hebrews 8:10.
Yeah.
For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel.
It show that they not part of that covenant and they not, the Lord not about binding them, because you know we a house, that mansion, to prove that they not part of that new covenant. Go ahead.
After those days, said the Lord,
come on,
I will put my law in their inward, in their minds, and in their, and written them in their inward hearts.
Go ahead.
And I will be to them a God, they shall be to me a people.
Go ahead.
And they shall not teach every man his neighbor, and every man his brother, saying, know the Lord.
Why? Because he's gonna send the comforter, man. All right, go ahead.
All shall know me.
All the elect, those who walk according to the rule, not the whole nation of Israel. Go ahead.
From the least to the greatest.
From the least to the greatest, come on.
For I will be merciful.
He will do what?
Be merciful.
To what?
To their unrighteousness.
For the love of money.
For the love of money.
What I got in my pocket.
for the love of money.
A microchip.
For the love of money.
Cash, bro. Cash.
Biometrics.
For the love of money.
Terminator 2, huh?
For the love of money.
Your debit card with the chip in.
For the love of money.
Oh, money. Go ahead.
It's the root of all evil.
Not the microchip, bro.
Money is the... We got money. God. And it is evil.
That's the temptation, man.
That's the mark of the beast.
Hey, read that last one you read about the temptation.
It gonna bang him exactly. He said, and I will also keep thee from the hour of temptation.
Now, hold on. Stop right there. Because he says possible with the Lord.
Come on.
Not with men, but it's possible with the Lord. Referring to the elect. That's what he's going to keep from the hour of temptation. That's not going to sell their soul out for the money. Go ahead.
We shall come upon all the world. To try them.
Hey, rich and poor, free and bond, money, not the microchip.
To try them that dwell upon the earth.
Come on.
To test your spirit.
To try your spirit, man.
Hey, man, he said it all in scripture.
Come on, man.
Golly.
He said, for the love of money is the root of all evil.
Of all? What you just read?
Upon the whole world.
Come on,
for the love of money is the root of all evil.
And he calls it all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a law in their right hand. Not, why can't it be in your hand, bro? Why can't it be the works of your hand? These guys go to the extreme and say, it's a RFID microchip being inserted.
Private in interpretation.
Flesh. There you go. Flesh. Come on, bro.
Said, which was some coveted after they have erred.
Some coveted. And he talking about guys in the truth.
That's right. Because
regular, the majority of Israel don't got faith in the Lord.
No, don't even think about it.
We talk about those that's a part of the temple. So read that part of
the said, which was some coveted after they have erred from the faith.
Hold on, how you covet after money? That's what deacon is not.
And that covet is idolatry.
And lusting.
No.
You lusting for money.
That's right.
You covet, man. Like, what the guy named? Deacon Kana?
Yeah.
From IUIC? He was coveting money, man.
Yeah.
He wanted that bag. Carpenter covet money. What's the proof? Yeah. They make shirts and put them up for sale.
And they'll cut you out. I saw a video talking about somebody. Yeah, so what? We got the 501c3.
Who?
So,
why?
They'll curse you out, man. They nasty now.
We get money, man.
What's wrong with having money?
For the love of money is the root of all evil.
And if you covet after it, means you love it. So you guys clearly covet it. Go ahead,
You say, which while some coveted after, they have erred from the faith.
That's how y'all err from the faith, man.
Don't bring it into the temple,
bro. That's pornography. That's fornication.
That's right.
All
right? And pierce themselves through with many sorrows.
Pierce them through with the
Pierce themselves through with many sorrows.
Hey, man, he cut them off.
Is that
hard, man?
Hold on. Didn't the young man walk away sorrowful?
Yeah.
What did it say?
It said, and pierced themselves through with many sorrows.
The young man walked away sorrowful. Come on, because of that money, it wasn't had nothing to do with a chip. Go ahead.
It's like, you know, it's talking about brothers that's in the truth. That error from the faith. They need to get back on the right path. Plus, he left us. But thou, O man of Yahweh, flee these things.
Hey, don't walk. Flee.
Run.
Get the gas.
Right.
Punch me down. And that's talking to all you zombies, man. You one west zombies. Flee. Go ahead. Like we did, all these one west zombies.
Yeah.
Zombies. They mean they're spiritually dead.
Dead. Mental and spiritual.
Consciously dead.
Dead.
Go ahead.
It said, but thou, O man of Yahweh, flee these things.
Yeah. So if you, sorry, Salakia, if you're a man of the Lord, you'll get from around that man. Go ahead.
Follow after righteousness.
Come on, man.
Godliness, faith, love, patience, and meekness.
Yep.
Fight the good fight of faith, lay hold on to eternal life, whereunto thou art also called and hast professed a good profession before many witnesses.
A good profession meaning a good job, because that's our profession.
Exactly. What scripture is that?
First Timothy 6,
all the way to the bottom.
Revelation, the Lord said it again. Then why he said that? He said, behold, I come quickly. Hold thou fast which thou hast, that no man take thy crown.
No man.
Take your soul, man. Don't sell your soul, man.
Don't sell your soul.
Lord said, I'm coming, man. Have faith. I'm coming.
Have faith,
come
yeah.
Come on, man.
Get that Revelation 9 and
20. Oh, yeah.
Because the whole child forgot to read. He read up to 11.
Right.
And he didn't read 12.
What did he say?
I'm going to read 12.
Go ahead, bring it out for him.
He said, if others be partakers of this power over you, are not we rather? Nevertheless, we have not used this power, but suffered all things. At least we should hinder the gospel of Mashiach.
Man, come on, man.
Come on.
That's what they do, man. It's Revelation 9 and 20, man.
Yep.
And you can repent from idols, man.
That's right.
And money is another idol.
Yeah, it is.
Revelation
13 and 16. We're all going to be scripture.
And the rest of the men. Revelation 9 and 20. Because these guys tell you that you can't repent if you receive the so-called teaching. But that's not what the Bible says. Revelation 9 verse 20. And the rest of the men which were not killed by these plagues, yet repented not of the works of their hands.
Meaning you can repent from the works of your hands. Not from somebody inserting a RFID microchip under the flesh. That ain't what it's referring to.
So you can't get surgery, take it out.
And the rest of the men.
And the rest of the men.
Which were not killed by these plagues. It's at the end.
Yeah.
Yet repented not of the works of their hands. They ain't gonna repent.
Meaning you can't repent.
Yeah.
These guys didn't repent.
Come on.
From the works of their hands. This is what it's referring to when it says, read what you got up.
This is
13, 16. No,
calls of all, and both small and great.
He calls it all, small and great, like we just was reading.
Come.
All right, go ahead.
Rich or poor,
yep.
Free and bond,
yep.
To receive a mark.
Hold on. to get surgery.
Come on.
To get surgery.
Come on, man.
And get a RFID microchip inserted under your flesh. Read that part again.
It says to receive a mark in their right hand.
To receive a mark in their right hand. Read what you got out that last part again.
It says, yet repented not of the work of their hands.
That's what it's talking about, man. Look up the word right hand, huh?
That they should not worship devils.
That's G1188.
What it say,
Dexitos, the right hand, a place of honor,
a place of honor and authority. See, these guys honor, and money is the authority of these people.
That's the
badge of authority, man. The money.
That's right.
That's the right hand, bro.
You can't buy a goddamn snicker ball.
It said what? Honor and authority. What it say down in the Strong's at the bottom?
It say the right side hand, that which you usually takes right, the hand aside.
Yo, that's it on that. All right,
come on, man.
Now read what you got up.
It's like,
yeah.
It says, killed by these plagues, yet repented not of the works of their hands. That they should not worship devils.
That they should not worship devils.
And idols of gold.
And idols of gold. Now, what's gold?
Money.
Money, right. Man.
Oh, and yeah. Silver.
And what else?
And silver.
They got money
brass,
value.
And stone and of wood.
That's
materialistic.
Hey,
the gospel really simple.
Hey, come on, man.
More than that. Gotta follow them commandments. Gotta stick to it too. Through whatever happens out here.
That's right.
No matter who come up to you, tell you whatever.
Hey, the Messiah gave us everything we need to know. The Messiah, man. If you follow his word, you will be good, man.
Yeah. The good and the bad parts.
Hey, come. He said, verily, verily, I say unto you.
Say barely, barely. That's the Lord saying truly, truly. All right? That's what that means. Go ahead.
He that enter not by the door into the sheepfold, but climb up some other way
through the knowledge of Terry Cook. All right? Through the knowledge of your elder. All right? Trying to climb up through your money. Go ahead.
The same is a thief and a robber.
The same is a thief. All right? The same is a thief and a robber. Now, get it. Revelation.
Okay.
Go back to chapter, what that was, 3? No, about the 3. Three. Three.
Okay.
And then go to the last verse.
Okay.
Watch what it say. That word thieves, go ahead.
It's Revelation, was it 3?
That was 2 or 3, you was about to the devil. You got it?
It says, verse 22, he that have an ear,
that
was one.
What that is?
It says, Revelation 3 and 22.
That's the last verse?
Yeah, he that have an ear,
yeah, go ahead.
He said that about 4 times in scripture. Revelation 3, verse 22. He that have an ear, let him hear what the Spirit say unto the churches.
Oh, that's the last verse?
That's the last verse. Open.
Okay, we're gonna deal with that later. Go ahead.
And the sheep hear his voice.
Yeah.
and he called his own sheep by name,
yeah,
and leadeth them out.
Yeah.
And when he put forth his own sheep, he go before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. So you gonna know the Lord, man. You gonna know who's speaking to you. A lot of you guys know he's telling the truth. Man. You go and you look up the words and you research what he's saying. Ain't no denying it, man. Ain't no chip in the Bible. Ain't no missiles in here. Ain't none of that stuff, man. You cause some people to go off, man. And you gonna answer for that, man. You gonna answer for that. The Lord says the heaven filled in the paper that's fucked up.
Go ahead, up, read that, y'all.
This is our Revelations 3:20. Behold, I stand at the door.
Ooh, come
and
on.
Knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in to him and will sup with him.
So that's how we got the increase that we got. Because the Lord, that's that mansion. That's where the Lord said he gonna abide with them that keep his word.
Yeah.
With them the ones that truly love him. So he said he gonna abide with them. When you look up that word abide, it means to live. All right? To inhabit. All right? So the Lord start from the top. Huh?
This is Revelations 3:20.
Yeah.
Behold, I stand at the door.
Yeah.
And knock. If any man hear my voice,
yeah,
and open the door,
come on.
I will come in to him and will sup with him.
He said he gonna come into him. All right, and he gonna suck with you through the spirit.
Spirit.
All right, through those ministering spirits he got. Go ahead, huh?
And he with me.
Yep. Not you. Not with your elder.
God, come on, man.
Okay, read on. Go ahead, huh?
No Moses, see, man. You better get out of here. You going?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, that's it. Okay.
This ain't tank, man. Yeah, this ain't on Moses. It's like Revelation 20. Before you guys want to add to scripture.
Okay, good.
Revelation 22:18. For I testify to every man that hear of the words of the prophecy of this book.
Yeah.
If any man shall add unto these things, Yahweh will add unto him the plagues that are written in this book.
So hold on, man. You gotta read it slow. Okay. Let me read it slow.
Okay, come.
Let's
this
see.
Is Revelation 22:18.
Mm-hmm.
This is for you Aaron Russo guys.
Yeah, come on with
that. For I testify unto every man that hear the words of the prophecy of this book.
The words of the what, huh?
The prophecy of this book.
So, like we say, history can be argued. Yeah.
Come on.
We talk about prophecy here.
That's right.
All right?
Come
we
on.
We talk about prophecy here. So he say, testify to every man that hears the words of the prophecy of the Bible.
Knowing this verse that no prophecy
go ahead.
Of the scripture
of the what?
Of the scripture
of the book
private interpretation.
Is of any private interpretation.
Woo! Read that again
now. It says, for I testify to every man that hear the words of the prophecy of this book.
Go ahead.
If any man shall add unto these things.
So if you bring Terry Cook, Edomite ass in this temple, that's what the Lord said. You bring that devil in this temple, what he gonna do?
Yahweh shall add unto him the plagues.
The same plagues that we read in Revelation 9:20. If you don't repent, go ahead.
That are written in this book.
No, the plagues. Plagues that might be for to teach.
That are written in this book.
Esau history, man.
The plagues that are written.
Oh, no, the Terminator. The Terminator.
Hey, Mark Simpson
working at a nuclear plant, huh? Come on, man. It say this book.
Come on, man. UFOs coming out the sky, man. The man said this book, man.
Go ahead,
They are written in this book, man.
Come on, read on up.
If any man, shall take away from the words of the book of this prophecy.
Talk about it ain't volcano. Y'all took volcanoes from the Bible.
Woo.
All right?
Woo.
Come on, man.
Woo.
What's going to happen?
Yahweh shall take away his part.
Hold on. Oh, go ahead. I'm you not here.
Yahweh shall take away
Watch
his
this.
Part out of the book of life.
Hold on. Do it say part?
It's a part, huh? It's part.
What a place at. Go to the next. Top scripture. I know it says something about a spot or a place.
You want to go ahead?
Oh, in that same two verses.
Okay, so
let me go on. Read verse 18 and 19 again.
The house shall add unto him the plagues that are written in this book.
Go ahead.
And if any man shall take away from the words of the book of this prophecy.
Yeah.
Yahweh shall take away his part.
His spot. His spot.
The mansion.
The mansion.
God.
Remember? Hey, the Lord was playing a place. Where that place at? Over
come
there?
On. Come
no,
on.
It's a spot amongst the elect. So if you add, the Lord is going to take away your spot. Go ahead.
His part.
Knowing this verse, that no prophecy.
Now, if you've been in this thing 30 years, you should have known this 30 years ago, because the Lord said this is what you first got to know. Yeah. You feel me?
That's
go ahead.
That no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation.
The RFID microchip is a private interpretation. The missile doctrine is a private interpretation. Constantine being on the white horse is a private interpretation.
Come on.
The Assyrians being it's a private interpretation.
I'm behind you. It's Smith,
come on, man.
It's a private interpretation.
All that private interpretation, man. Go ahead up.
He said, for the prophecy came not in old times by the will of man.
What man bought in the RFID chip? Who willed that? Y'all talk about it. All right? So this ain't come by the will of man. Go ahead.
But holy men of Yahweh spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost.
The holy men of the Lord, bro.
Stone you.
In the Old Testament, you just be dead, dog.
Yeah.
You, well, that's how you know you're gonna
you break the law, you get stoned. They never shoot you. They let you stand there. They throw rocks at you until you die.
Can't get rid of this wicked people.
Nah.
Can't have no wicked people in a racist place.
Nah.
It ain't gonna work.
You had something?
No, that was it.
That was it? Well, let's get one last scripture, man. Okay. We close it up.
Okay.
Get that Proverbs 3:31. Yeah, but then we'll cut it.
Brought it out.
The light source.
He brought it out.
It has no surface, man. The moon is a lesser light. Yeah. It has no, you can't let on nothing.
Let prove
you get that brother Chris. He got heat.
So he read this before.
Yeah.
This is how he know. But if he didn't know, we're gonna get
it. It made sense to him.
Go ahead, bro.
This is Genesis 1:14.
Yeah.
And Yahweh said, let there be lights in the
firmament. Yeah. Plural lights. Go ahead.
In the day.
Hold on. He say lights in the midst, in the firmament.
Right.
Not out in the galaxy. In the firmament that he created earlier in the chapter. Go ahead.
To divide the day from the night.
Let's see what those lights is.
And to let them be for signs and for seasons yeah, for days and for years. Verse 15.
Yeah.
And let them be for lights in the firmament of heaven, is to give light unto the earth.
So can you go to the moon and take go to the beach and take a swim? The Lord ain't talking about, he didn't say he put no water on them.
Right.
Put no land. When he created the earth, he tell you.
Exactly.
Earth, then the waters, I divided it. You know, the earth.
He never said that about the moon.
He said two great lights.
Hey, like you can't collect no moon rocks.
You can't land on a light.
You can't land on a light, man.
Read on the
phone. It's a big moment of energy,
right? He said, let there be lights in the firmament of heaven,
yeah,
to give light unto the earth. And it was so.
And it was so. They lights, man.
And God made two great lights. Woo! The greater light to rule the day.
Okay, so the Lord made the sun.
Great lights.
That's a great light.
And the white man will tell you that we can't land on the sun. The Lord said,
the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night.
So it's a light.
And he made light. The stars also.
And he made the stars, and that's what you can't live on those stars.
In the firmament.
In the firmament. You can't leave outside the
You can't
firmament.
Leave here.
Now read what you got. Look at the clothes on this. This go right with it. Go ahead.
Proverbs 31:3-31. Envy thou not the oppressor.
So don't try to be like the so-called white man. Obviously, the brother Stephen Curry was not doing that because he went contrary. All right, but Elder Tahar, all right, wants to be 30 years service in the temple. All right, I don't even need to carry cook doctrine. But this brother, you know, he said no, he went against the white man.
I don't believe
the white man. All right, read what you got.
And choose none of his ways.
Don't choose none of the so-called white man ways. That go for Stephen Curry, and that go for Elton.